Tonight, the battle for the Pacific. As Australia ramps up its diplomatic engagement, China is hit with stiff opposition from our island neighbours. So has Beijing overplayed its hand? In the Pacific, the tide may be turning. Today, Beijing vowed it will continue pushing for a trade and security deal with the Pacific Islands the day after the deal was rejected by the 10 nations.
Of course, there are some concerns on some specific issues.
The rejection of the deal wasn't the only bad news for China. PNG has slammed an unusually timed visit from the Chinese foreign minister on the eve of the country's election as
premature and irresponsible.
While Australia is preparing to deploy 100 ADF personnel to PNG to assist with the vote.
Pacific Island countries really value not only their own sovereignty but their own individual personality. So I think China's made an error in trying to bracket all these countries together and to hustle them into signing an agreement that they haven't really thought about.
In recent weeks, there's been a fierce charm offensive from both China and Australia. Our new foreign minister jetting off to the region in her first week on the job.
And Australia will be a partner that doesn't come with strings attached.
But as Penny Wong toured the islands, so too did her Chinese counterpart, Wang Yi, also hoping to woo the nation's leaders.
Foreign ministers visit to Solomon Islands and the seven other countries is very significant for us.
China made some headway, signing deals with Samoa and Kiribati on the top of last month's deal with the Solomons. But its mission to win over more has failed due to the strong opposition from Palau and Micronesia, both worried about the long-term effects of a deal with Beijing.
Well, I think it tells us that Chinese influence in the Pacific is not an inevitability, but at the same time, I think it's a signal from China that they intend to grow their influence and to disrupt the interests of countries like Australia, New Zealand and the United States.
So with China vowing to fight on, what will the coming months bring in this battle for the Pacific?
Dr Anna Powles is a senior lecturer in security studies at Massey University in New Zealand. She joins us now. Dr Powles, what have you made of all this? Was China's deal always going to fail or did they fumble the ball?
Kia ora. Great question. Certainly from what we understand over the past week, there was strong resistance to the deal from the outset, concerns about the lack of consensus building around the arrangement. So it didn't come as any surprise when we heard yesterday that it had been shelved.
Well, the Pacific nations obviously have their own concerns and interests that have very little to do with Australia. Are you able to gauge how much effect Penny Wong's tour had?
I think from the perspective of Australian engagement with the Pacific following the election of the new government, it was an incredibly important visit. It arguably was not the factor that determined the outcome of this deal. That was driven very much by Pacific interests themselves, by the interests of the 10 Pacific states involved. But certainly in terms of progressing and getting off to a really good start from an Australian perspective, Senator Wong's visit was welcomed in Fiji, and she certainly hit the right notes.
So if China finds themselves unable to do a deal with the region as a whole, won't they just try to get as many of these individual deals as possible?
Well, that's probably where they're heading, and they're certainly going to... doesn't mean that they're not going to keep pursuing a regional approach, that multilateral approach with the 10 states that recognise China. But given the fact that they haven't been successful, that they have overplayed their diplomatic hand in this respect, shoring up those bilateral agreements is going to be really important, because this is also about, you know, wins for China and for Chinese foreign policy and wins back home too, as well. So they're going to want to see a degree of success to really benefit the reason why, I mean, Minister Wong has spent so much time here in the Pacific.
I think for many Australians, it's difficult to understand why suddenly there's this rush of diplomacy and territory staking out in the Pacific. Is it because there's a fear that eventually America and China might go to war and suddenly these remote islands become crucial strategic launch pads?
Well, I think we need to be really careful about the way that we frame these issues. From the Pacific perspective, you know, the number one security interest is climate change. understandably. And there is deep concern that Pacific countries are being drawn into a conflict not of their making. And as, you know, tensions between China and the United States increasingly heighten, that the Pacific countries will be either forced to choose between the two sides, which raises a whole host of challenges for them, given their development and economic interests, and that they will be placed in a, you know, very difficult position between traditional partners such as Australia and New Zealand and China, as well as the, as concerns about any kind of conflict manifesting in the region as well. Of course, you know, the Pacific has seen that before in World War II.
Well, the story isn't going anywhere. Dr. Anna Powles, thank you very much for your time.
Thank you. Thank you for having me.